Home sweet home. Friday evening, and there's an emergency?
This is serious business. Sebastian Husher is nowhere to be found, and his manuscript should have been at the office by Tuesday. He won't answer his calls, and he hasn't shown up at his office at the university. He's vanished into thin air.
Don't screw with me, Etienne. Call him on Monday, or send a courier for him. I just got in the door less than 5 minutes ago.
I go myself, but I've got to attend Albert's performance in half an hour. Plus, Husher's house is closer to your place than it is to mine. Come on, man. The sooner you go, the sooner you'll get back home.
You're going to owe me a big fat favor.
Whatever you want. Write this down. 4 Abbott Thomas Road, in the old housing developments along Highway EB-15.
EB-15? Good God, that's out in the sticks. I plan to take a few days off after this.
Well, we'll talk about that once you find him. Oh, and if he gives you the manuscript, don't show it to anyone. And don't go selling it off to the highest bidder.
I'll see what I can do. We'll ring you up when I get back.
Thanks, Dan. You're saving my skin.
Again. Another Friday evening and I'm working as an errand boy. I suppose they're too important over at Wake Publishers to come looking for jolly old Husher themselves. Shit. Even I should be too important for that. I mustn't overstretch my complaints. Rising from my lot as a drunkard and financial ruin to that of an errand boy is actually quite an improvement. If only things had gone a bit better for the company, or I'd got on the wagon a bit sooner. Damn, Sophie did the right thing when she divorced me. I would have divorced myself in her place. Daniel Neuer, a bloody alcoholic. Chin up, Hugh. That is Daniel Neuer, the bloody ex-alcoholic, after all. Wake Publishers employee by day, Wake Publishers screwed over lackey by evening. Even Friday evenings. But if I could find Husha, I have a feeling my status at the company would rise quite a bit. After all, he is the publishing firm's biggest star. Let's cross our fingers and hope he's home. Hello? Is that music? I'd better take a look. Someone playing a music box. Thank you. something on that doorknob. Hardly taken a step forward when I heard the door close behind me. When I turned around, the door wasn't there anymore, and all that was left of it was a strange shadow on the wall. I searched, I despaired, and I screamed until my throat began to burn. The candles started to run out, as did the batteries in my torch. From within the most suffocating darkness, the hours went by until turning into days, and I began to fall in and out of a restless sleep. I would hear voices, sometimes right next to me, other times a few yards away. It seemed like they were coming from the other side of the wall. Desperate cries, howling in horror, and sometimes, the worst of all, a vast, oppressive silence would fall, seeming to emanate from everywhere and nowhere all at once. There was nobody there. Just hallucinations, nightmares, black nothingness, and the song from that music box. Trapped in this impossible place, I wondered if I was going to die there.
Etienne, do you have any news on Daniel yet?
Oh, Sophie. No. We've been calling him at home all day, but there's no response. Do you know if he's got a mobile phone?
No, I don't think so. And if he does, he doesn't tend to keep it on him.
Oh, man. I think I should pass by the Husher place when I leave, just to see if they know anything.
Husher the writer? Your client?
Yeah. I sent Daniel over there on Friday, and I haven't heard from him since.
What's the address? I'm going to stop by Daniel's place, and if I don't find him, I can go around and ask about him.
The house on the outskirts of town, on Highway EB-15. Number 4, Abbott Thomas Road. It's a big house.
Okay. I'm headed over. Call me if you find him.
Of course. Same to you.
The door was open. Is there anybody home? Uh-uh.
Thank you. Huh.
There's something on the counter. Yes. What was that? I didn't hear anything in there. The phone. Should I answer? Hello? Sorry, who is this? I can't understand you.
We can't leave my room.
What the? It sounded like a child. Is he in the house? Yes. Huh. Daniel. Is that you? That door.
Thank you.
Yes. That room looks really dark. Thank you. Yes. Finally. Daniel, if you're here, I'm going to find you.
There's a wardrobe. Get in!
Thank you.
that for real? Or am I imagining things? Oh, God. Is there someone on the other side? I have to get in there.
Yes. now.
It really stinks in here. Ew. Things stop shaking.
Yes.
Done. Although I'm not sure if I should be relieved, to be honest. Thank you. Hey, Julia? Are you okay? What is this? It's a good thing I'm not wearing high heels. Hello? Anybody there? I don't get it. I just don't get any of this. Poor bird. Probably died instantly.
was I?
Thank you.
Uh-huh. Oh, yuck.
My God, what is that thing? So there's more than one. Things stop shaking. Yes. Thank you. The fire was definitely the best place for that hideous thing. What on earth is that door doing there?
Where am I?